Hey guys, if you're just visiting for the very first time, then welcome, of course. I hope you'll stick around a while by hitting that subscribe button so that you don't miss a beat and you're up to date on all of my frugal finds. Now, if you're a current subscriber, then welcome back, of course. So I'm going to make this introduction as short and brief as possible because I have a pretty substantial size haul that I want to share with you guys today. So if you're interested in some of the unexpected finds I was able to score this time around, then of course, all you have to do is keep right on watching. So if you've ever seen any of my past hauls before, then you know it's not uncommon for me to pick up things in multiples of two and sometimes three. Simply because for the most part, I usually pick up one and then one for a backup in case I never see it again, or, you know, just for symmetry, depending on how I'm going to use it and its functional purpose. So although this haul is pretty substantial in size and it looks, you know, voluminous, there's a lot of things that are in multiples. And let me just say that that goes to show you how Dollar Trees differ from store to store and location to location, because what a difference just a week makes. I was there just a couple of days ago and my store looked like it got hit by a bomb. The shelves were barely empty. And at the stuff that they did have available looked all picked over. And this time around, I was able to score a lot of unexpected things that I didn't expect to see. And the trucks are still coming in. You know, they got behind and delayed. So usually by this time, they don't really restock any of the fall or Halloween stuff, and they just move right on to Christmas. But ironically, my store has been still stocking fall and Halloween. So I was able to pick up a couple of each. Even if I don't use it this year, I can always put it away for next year. So enough of that. So for example, they had these little bottles that came late in the game, as far as I'm concerned, but they had three different variations. They had this one that says it's fall, y'all. And then this one says, leaves are falling, autumn is calling. I'm sorry, it's very light. And then this one with just the buffalo check leaf. And I just noticed that my little cork is missing. It must have popped out in the bag, so I only have two with cork. But I thought they were cute, and had they had them soon enough, I could have used them in a DIY craft for Halloween that I did with some potion bottles. I could have repurposed these, but there's always next year. And then another thing that I seen other people haul a while ago already, and they came to my Dollar Trees. They finally made their way around, and were these little gnomes. Now they have them in three different colors. They have them in red. They have like a light powder, almost baby blue, and then this green. The red, which is the most popular, that one seemed to fly off the shelf right away. The lady told me as soon as she busted open up the box, those went right away. And then the blue. So the greens were a little picked over, but they were the only ones left. So I grabbed two because you know how my motto is, if it's not the color that you want, then make it the color that you need. Another Christmas item I found was this stinking adorable little Santa cup. It's pretty small, but you know, as far as drinking coffee or hot chocolate or whatever, you're only going to get like maybe 3 ounces. But I would style this in like a tea tray and put some maybe candy canes hanging from it or something. So I thought it was cute. And of course, if you don't like the color and it doesn't go with your aesthetics, you can always paint it as well. Then I stumbled across these little bowls, which I thought were adorable with the buffalo check pattern. And they just have this little like a twisty tie that you stick them on with. You have to check them because a lot of them were beat up and they were, you know, like shedding. I guess they're meant to be like organically rustic or whatever, but I did notice a substantial amount of fraying on a lot of them. Like really, strings were just all over the place. So I had to kind of pick through them before I could get two pretty decent packs. I grabbed two packs of this faux snow from Crafter Square. I figured I could use them in a couple of DIYs. Then I also found this cute little gingerbread girl. She's so adorable with her little bow. I figured I can personalize it. And so I grabbed her. I was looking for the elves, but they didn't have them yet. Then as far as ornaments, I found a couple of acrylic ones. I only picked up these two ballerinas. They look like they're acrylic, but they're plastic. And so they're these little ballerinas that I thought were adorable. And then I only picked up one of the deer. They have another one that's not, this is an ornament. This is the intended purpose of this one is to hang it from the tree. But there is another one circulating out there that it's like a standalone and you can put it like on a shelf or a tier tray. I'm still on the hunt for that one. Then I also grabbed just one of these skis. It's just a little ornament as well, hung by a jute rope, and it says ski lift on them. This is another one that you had to look through carefully because they are shedding a lot of glue and some of them were broken on the tip over here. This is like cardboard, so a lot of them were snapped in half. So I only grabbed the one because of that. Then I grabbed one more of the galvanized houses. Now they come in the galvanized. They have the red and they have the green. But this is what I mean about checking over your things, because I didn't notice until I got home that it's missing the little tea light holder. Here, I'll show you. I actually hauled this one in my last haul. And I'll link it in the description bar down below of my haul where I purchased this one. I just got the one. And so it has a little tea light holder inside that little circle thing, if you see there. And so this one doesn't have it. So, I mean, it's not a big deal. It's still fully functional, but I grabbed it to, you know, do a little display with both of these houses. Another ornament that I picked up was this adorable little ski, and it's has like a buffalo check pattern with the fur. I thought it was cute, but I only grabbed the one because honestly, I have enough ornaments for my tree. So the ones that I pick up, I'll probably use them in DIYs except for these. These definitely will be going on my tree because I thought they were adorable, and they're actually, let me see what they're labeled as. They're just labeled as ornaments or decorations, but they're from the Christmas House brand, and they come with 6 pieces per pack. So this is a set of 12 right here, and they're like fur icicles. They feel like wool. It's kind of like a fuzzy material fabric. It's hard to show up on camera. But I thought they were really nice for like a winter wonderland theme. So that was my theory behind picking up these. Then I found some of the pom-pom trim, and I just picked up 2 packs of the white. Now these come in red and green and in white. But like I said, I'm going with a winter wonderland theme. So only the white interests me, and these seem to be the ones that go the quickest. So I saw them, so I had to grab them. Then I picked up a couple of packs of wooden ornaments just to craft with the wood shapes. I got some of these here snowflakes. I got the snowman. The snowman is an 8-pack. The snowflakes are 14. And then the gingerbread wooden shapes are also 14 pieces. So I grabbed some of those for some crafts. Also for some crafts, I grabbed some of these. These aren't new. These come out every year. And they're just the mittens, the candy canes, and the glittered stockings. So I picked up a pack of those to craft with. Then I found some new galvanized ornaments. I picked up the Christmas tree. And I picked up the ornament ball to do some DIY crafting with. This was new, also late to the game, this little tea light pumpkin. I'm not crazy about the sheen. It has like a shiny polish to it, so I'm probably gonna paint over it. Even though I like the color that it is, I'll probably paint over it with some chalk paint just to, you know, dull it down a little. I found some fab quarters too that I thought were really cool. I grabbed the buffalo check pattern, and then this one that has the little red trucks on it here. Why don't I just open it up so I can show you? So this is the one with the truck pattern. It has the little red truck with the tree in it against this black background. I thought it was really pretty. I mean, you can do, the opportunities are limitless for the DIY potential that these have. You can make gnomes, you can make pillows. And then I got the buffalo check pattern because this lends itself well to Winter Wonderland as well as, you know, any other themes. So lastly, well, not lastly for the decor because I still have more, but I picked up some of these foam sheets in the shape of a gingerbread man because they come with 12 pieces to the pack, and I plan on doing a craft with these as well. This was new that I thought was so stinking adorable. I actually picked up two, one for me and one for my granddaughter. I just felt that it lends itself because of, you know, my channel. I am a content creator, so I thought it was cute. And it's just like one of these production role scene things, and it does actually function. So I picked up one for me and one for my four-year-old grandbaby, my toddler four-year-old. She thinks she's a YouTuber as well, so I'm sure she'll get a kick out of this. And then speaking of her, I also found this little reindeer, and it's a little advent calendar. It has the Velcro strip that you just change it around for the days. I figured she could hang this on her bedroom door and then count down the days until Christmas. And it's just made of felt, so it's probably pretty easy to make, but for a dollar, I'm not gonna complain. They took the work out for me, and I thought it was adorable, and I had to pick it up. Then something else that was brand new at the Dollar Tree, I had never seen before. They have, I mean, they've always had canvases, but always the whites. And so now they have black canvases, guys. I was so excited to see them. They only had this one size, which is the 8x10 for now, but I'm sure other sizes will start making their way around eventually. But for now, they just had the 8x10 size, and I am not mad about it. So I grabbed two. And then also I found some, these were also late to the game. This is fall related as well. And they're just rub-on transfer stickers that you can put on like stemless wine glasses, but they're not only, you know, you don't always have to use things for their intended purposes. You don't only have to put it on a stemless wine glass, is what I'm trying to say. You can use these for other craft projects as well. And I picked up these three variations. This one that says pumpkin spice and everything nice, happy fall y'all, and hello autumn. So I was happy to have been able to grab these three. And if I don't use them this year, like I said, there's always next year. I also grabbed this one pack of velour scrunchies. They're like a velvety velour, and I just really like the patterns. I like this little cheetah pattern, the cheetah print, and then the black, the solid black, and then the cream color. So they appealed to me, and I grabbed them. I also needed some duct tape and white for a project, so I grabbed that roll. And last but not least was this Essentials brand lint roller, and this is the bonus buy with the travel one. So you get two. They also have the one that just brings the one for the same price, so you might as well get this one that comes with a bonus travel one. So I grabbed it. I figured I can keep this one in my car and this one at the house. And that's it, guys. That's all she wrote. That's it for this haul. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you were able to see something that you might want to try to venture out and go see if you can find it at your local Dollar Trees. And until my next video, I'll meet you back here. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye now.